dude!
Something's broken our fall.
Along with my collarbone.
I better get out there and balance this thing out, baby bro. Yeah. Turns up! Righteous!
Cowabunga!
Arvel, who is this crazy guy?
George Cayley, dude's father of aerodynamics and happening wingwalker. Welcome to my glider. No engine, but she's powered by the wind. Killer, huh?
Well, don't you think you better get in there and steer this thing?
Negatory, dude. There is no steering.
No steering.
No steering!
Ah! Well, I guess I should have invented the ambulance instead.
Dear Diary, May 20th, 1927. Today I'm flying the Spirit of St. Louis, nonstop from New York to Paris. What are you boys doing here?
Bleeding internally.
Who are you?
Well, I'm Charles Lindbergh, and this is supposed to be a solo flight across the Atlantic Ocean. Yeah, I figure it should take about 33 and a half hours to fly the, 3,600 miles. But, you know, I can't seem to keep my ears from popping. Any suggestions?
Chewing gum. Isn't that right, Wilbur?
Yeah, but once you land, it's hard to get the stuff out of your ears.
Chuck, are you sure you have enough fuel to make it across the Atlantic Ocean?
Well, I have 451 gallons of gasoline and a full thermos of coffee. You better make that 451 gallons of coffee and a full thermos of gasoline.
By the way, Chuck, before we crash, do you know who built and flew the first engine-powered airplane?
Well, I'm pretty sure it was two fellas back at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, on December 17th, 1903. Orville and Wilbur Wright.
Hey, Orville, it was us.
And do you know how long that first flight lasted?
I'll look it up just a second.
Close. It was actually 12 seconds. Oh, call me Lucky Lindy. Looky here. I found another thermos of fuel.
Whew.
Yeah, but like I told you boys before, I'm, you know, flying this thing solo, so...
Hey,
hey, is this Paris?
Oui, oui!
We're going to get letters.
Mission accomplished, sir.
It was us, the Wright brothers, who built and piloted the first engine-powered airplane.
Good work, boys!
Orville, the next time we do this, remind me to take the train.